In this video, I'm going to show you how to use a macro to create a master list of documents. Here I have a basic quote. So we have the quote number, and we'll put any number in there, the customer and the date, and then we are going to the prices for parts, labor, and then a total. Now, we'd like to have this list of all our quotes going onto one master list, and I've made basically a master list quote sheet that has the quote number, customer, quote price, quote date, and basically it has everything that you want to record on your quotes. So I'm going to create a button on my sheet so that it will automatically record quotes in this master list. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to my developer tab here. And from the toolbox in the drop-down list here, I am going to select the button, and I'm going to insert the button in the bottom here. And so then I'm going to right-click this button, and I'm going to go to Properties, and I'm going to change the caption from Command Button 1. I'm going to change it to Record in List. And so then we'll close this. So let's say it's quote number 75. We'll call the customer Brown Ink, and let's say the date is 01/02/2017, and so let's put some parts. The parts are $150, and the labor would probably be $300 if it's $150. And so there's our total price. So this is what we need to bring over to our list. We need the 75 as the quote number, the brown ink as the customer, the date, and the price. So we want to record those in our list. So let's double click on our button here. And then we go to our command button macro. And so what we're going to do here is, first of all, is we're going to define some variables. So I'm going to put some extra spaces in here. And then I'm going to go dim. And I'm going to say quote as string. And then I'm going to define, so I'm going to go dim customer as string. Define price as string, and I'm going to go define dim queue date, which is at being the quote date, as string. Okay, I'm going to go dim E row, and I'm defining my E row as N row as long, and dim my data as worksheet. I'm sorry, workbook. Okay, so the next step, I always do it in select the sheet and the cell, and don't ask me why, but it doesn't work for me just doing selecting the sheet once. So let's go worksheet, quotation marks, sheet one, quotation marks, end of bracket, And we're going to go dot select. Oops. And then we're going to go quote, making sure my case is the same as how I've defined it up in the top. And we're going to go range. Now, if we go back, we can check this out. And our quote number is range B2. And so we're going to go range. And then we're going to go and quotation marks and into brackets. Okay, and then we're going to go, I'm going to copy this worksheet again. Like I said, it's supposed to work without it, but I do it every time and it seems to work better for me this way. And then I'm going to go customer. Equals. Range. D2. And I'm going to go worksheet select. And I'm going to go control V. Q date. Equals. G2. And I'm going to go price is the last one. All right. Now we've defined our variables. So I'm going to do, next thing is I'm going to set my sheet. Equals workbook. Dot open. Okay, and then now you have to define where the sheet that you're going to put it into is. So my trick to this is you actually go to your file. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the file folder, and I'm going to get the actual address to where my file is located. So I'm going to copy that, and then I'm going to go back to my Visual Basic, and I'm going to put a quotation mark. And I'm going to put that in, and then I'm going to put another backslash, and then I'm going to put the name of my file, which is master quote list dot xlsx, and then I'm going to go in the quotation mark and in the bracket. So that has defined where the sheet that we're going to enter the stuff in is located. And now I'm going to go worksheet quotation mark sheet 1 dot select. Now I'm going to go worksheet sheet 1 dot range, and I'm going to go to range, go to the top, right? So I'm going to start at the top so I can start where I'm going. Okay, and the next thing I'm going to define is my end row. So my end row is the end of the active sheet, right? So the active sheet is where the data ends. So I'm going to go E row equals worksheets. And I'm going to go quotation mark sheet one, quotation mark end of it. And I'm going to go dot range. And I'm going to start at the top. Now, current region. Dot rows. Dot count. Good. Now I'm going to do a with statement. So with work A1. And now I'm going to offset to put my data in here. So let me scroll this up so we can see it. So I'm going to go dot offset. Now the rows is going to be at the end row, or the offset is going to be the end row. And the first one I'm not going to move at all, so I'm just going to go zero to offset vertically. And I'm going to go equals quote. And then I'm going to go paste it. And so I'm going to go offset one. And I'm going to call this one customer. And then I'm going to paste it again. And I'm going to offset two. And I'm going to call this one price. And one more time, and I'm going to call this the last one queue date. So, or end my with. Then I'm going to save my master sheet, which is my data. Now let's go, and we have an end sub at the end there. Okay, so now I've gone back to my master sheet here, and then I'm going to click on record in list. So there's my master sheet now. It has the quote number of 75, it has the brown ink, it has the $450, and it has the date of the quotation being made. So that's how you record your documents in a master list using a macro. Please subscribe.